Hi there. 4 years ago, I bought this bicycle at Decathlon, 400 euros. I'm not so unsatisfied about the quality. I think for 400 euros, it's a reasonably good bike. Until a few months ago, I started to have a problem. So I brought it to a repair shop, asked, please fix it, and they immediately said, a Decathlon bike is not what we're going to repair. So I brought it to the Decathlon repair shop and then the story started. So I will explain you what difficulties I encountered and how I fixed it. So this is what happened. As I said, not a bad bike, but after some time this freewheel, you can hear it turn in the freewheel direction. If you start to pedal, it locks into place and the wheels will start to turn. But in my case, after 4 years, the freewheel gave way. It started to jump over. Actually, this is the one version I cannot turn it, but if you really put force, then it will just freewheel in the wrong direction. So, I'm not explaining how to take off the cassette. There are excellent YouTube movies to show you that. So I took off this cassette and started to look at this. I forgot to say. So first, I brought it to the Decathlon shop. And these guys, they ordered this one. And this is the one that you can get on the Decathlon website. It is called the Rock Rider cassette body. But this isn't the right one. You cannot order the right one on the Decathlon website. So the right one means this is my wheel. Evo double wall rim 6063 disc only. So this is my wheel. So this freewheel hub, by the way, there are several names. Sometimes it's called a cassette body. Sometimes it's called a free hub body. It's always called also called a freeway hub. All these terms are used, and so at Decathlon they bought the wrong one, but on top of it, they didn't know how to remove it, because you need an 11 millimeter, I forgot the English name for this, inbussleutel in Dutch. So this is a kind of conversion tool to get from 8 millimeter to 11 millimeter. So this one you can buy. So on shops, web shops where they sell free hubs, you can also buy this tool. And sometimes, like in my case, it gets sent to you like this. So the tool is already in there for you. Okay, so the way to remove it, I already removed all the balls and the axle. So if you have done that, then it's pretty easy. There are two ways to do it. You can go from this way and turn. I've seen a YouTube video with a guy who did it from the other way, but then you have to turn it the other way around to get it out. So this is the way to get it out. Fairly easy. Now you get this, and you can already see that what they recommended for me Actually, the guys at Decathlon, they bought this one, but you need this one. So, once I got it out, actually, I got it out without this tool. There was a friend of mine who created a similar tool like this. Maybe you can recognize it. He just created it from some broken tool. You can see in this way. It's a bit more inconvenient because you cannot stick it in like this. You have to go from the other way and then say from this way you put it in. But okay, that's some creative. Thanks, Steph. Good work. So finally I got the right tool. And now about how did I get the right part. Actually, I was a bit lucky, I think. My first effort was to find candidates, and so this was not the right one. And I had five candidates. So the bottom one, I couldn't order it anywhere, couldn't find it. And the top one seems to have a slightly different weight, less weight than, so these ones had the right weight. So I ordered all three of them, and with the intent to send it back. So the good thing is, finally the one that fitted for me was the 506. So the 506 is the right one, but the difference is really, really small. So it's actually the same. Let me see if I still have this 506. I'm not going to send it back to the shop because they delivered it along with this tool. So I kept it just in order to have this tool for the future. And so, yeah. So to show you the differences, so this is a brand new 506. You can see there's a little rim. There's a rim like this, probably to keep the balls better in place. Don't think it has a, or maybe to keep some dirt out. So the old one has this rim in this place, but you can, this one is the old one, you can see that it has a kind of, yeah, it's kind of circular, yeah, we call it the, I don't know the English word for it, but anyway, it contains the bearing balls in its place and they roll in a kind of circle in this containing, it's kind of, yeah, like a dish. And so this is the X9V2, at least it arrived like that with this. I'm still doubtful if this still is the one, but you can see there's almost no difference. It's just a slight, yeah, the slight difference in the curvature of this dish. So what was sent to me, so the two X9s, I could not see any difference between the two. So there's a V2 and there's this one. So, but I'm, yeah, not commenting on that. One of them I sent back, the other one I kept for the tool, and I started to use the 506. Okay, so yeah, that's basically it. I think putting it together is pretty trivial, so I hope this has helped you. If you have this problem, then here's the new one. I'm going to celebrate putting it in. And hope you enjoyed the video, and good luck with your bike. Thank you.